what's important about keeping the culture alive. For me, it's that identity of our people of the bygone days. And reassuring them in spirit that it continues, that it's not dead. There's so many times people say that, oh, you know, that's dying, or this is, you know, if you don't do it, it's gonna die. But it's a reassurance to our ancestors that it's not. It may be tweaked a little because what they used then and what we use today is a little bit different. But keeping within your heart and in your spirit, those things that they did through prayer, through having the value of family and that strength that they get from nature and what's around them, it's wonderful.
Auntie Paulette was a great example of the value of kuleana because she saw it as her responsibility to share the Hawaiian culture, as that was her skill. She was a very skilled featherwork as well as generations before her. So for her to teach that to us, it did help me realize that this is a skill that's being taught to us. So we should be able to teach it to other people and share it with other people so that the culture will be perpetuated.
Luau is such a big event here. It takes up so much time and energy that we really come together as a club and as a school to put it on.
Never thought of dancing hula at all. It's just, I came here and like all my friends are like, oh, Luau, like it's huge, let's go do it. And I was like, all right, I'll try it.
I'm brand new to this whole thing and I didn't realize like how much work it is just to do something so small, like just to instruct a group of people is already so hard, and I didn't realize I was going to take on all this responsibility, but it's great. It's teaching me so much.
After being in a couple leadership roles, I noticed that even though people look up to a certain person, such as Bridget or Kobe, as you know, running this thing, honestly, we have so many meetings and there's so much collaboration that everything that's done in Luau and everything that gets accomplished is through help and through a team.
I'm a dancer, but this is my first year instructing as well as being on Luau board or going to the meetings. So I feel like it's finally coming full circle for me, being able to see both behind the scenes aspects as well as the actual performance.
This year, I'm gonna dance in Tininkling, and they do a traditional version and a modern version, and I'm getting to do the modern version. I think as a faculty member, I don't participate to the same degree that they do, but it's getting that little glimpse, right, of what they're experiencing and how huge it is. To me, the importance of Luau to Pacific is, you know, in a sense, part of our mission in terms of appreciating diversity, just the exchange of culture and ideas.
The Luau board does so much to put this on as well because they're also behind the scenes. They're in charge of everything. They're like the head of the students, and then there's Auntie Edna who also does a lot too.
Well, I'd have to say facilities, because they do a lot, setting up the stage and setting up a whole bunch of different things, making sure everything's running right. And they usually never get any credit. No one really knows who they are, just definitely behind the scenes.
I think the biggest person that really is behind the scenes is Auntie Hope Villanueva. She's an advisor for the Hawaii Club. She's always there to give positive energy and influence us to do better.
We have a lot of donations that come in, and we sell stuff at Country Store to raise money for the club. So there's a lot of donors out there too that probably don't get much recognition.
parents for sure. Parents come up like week or week before to help with whatever we need, to fix costumes, to make lays. They help us with everything.
This is a student-run chill, but we're still students. We still need guidance from our parents, and our parents are like back at home having meetings and making sure we're all on the right track.
Everybody tries their very best to make sure that they do give credit to the parents, but I mean, there's always more that we can do for them because they do so much for us.
Well, just shout out to all the seniors, the last year.
Like, Luau's always been special, but senior year, it's like the last one I'm gonna be in. So it's pretty big for me. Yeah, I'm excited for it too.
My favorite part about Luau is the actual show, that Saturday night. You know, we prepare months for this show, and to see it finally all come together, that is one of the most rewarding feelings, to see 200 students come together to put on the show for 2,000, and we get to share our cultures and cultures from all around Polynesia. And it's just amazing to see everything come together, from the lighting committees to dance and everything. Just, it's like magic almost. Yeah.
Kapuhala pulika e hukaie, ala mai o kumuka. kahi hae hae o lane tione. Te one o kai mua o haina ea. Au mai o pana e wakana hele. O au ke au I kaliko le hua. Ma lama lama o lai ka vauna hele. Ma liu mai ka leo ka hea e. E o mai, e o mai e.
Mai kai ke mai luna mai e o na me a una no e o o na me le e ho mai e ho mai e ho mai e ho mai kai ke mai luna mai e o na me a una no e o O na mele, e ho mai, e ho mai, e ho mai e.
Aloha Ahiai, and welcome to Pacific University's Naha Mana o Hawaii 55th Annual Luau.
Every year, the young men and women of Naha Mana o Hawaii, along with the help and support of their beloved advisors and families, work tirelessly to put together this annual luau. The amount of time and dedication necessary to put together this amazing event may seem very overwhelming in the beginning stages of planning, but with the hard work and dedication of all involved, we are able to repeatedly present to you this show.
This year's theme for our 55th annual luau is Aohe Hana Nui Kealuia, which translates to No Task is Too Big When Done Together. This motto is a lifestyle that we live here and keep close to heart here at Pacific University. Throughout the night, you may see some familiar faces dancing, chanting, and even up here at the podium. To add a special twist to this monumental year, we have asked alumni for their help and support in putting this all together. By bringing together the past and the present members of our Pacific family, we have a show that we're proud to present to all of you today. In Hawaiian culture, an ole is used to ask for permission, whether it is to enter a sacred area or to ask to use the resources of our land, knowledge, and traditions. This year, the current students chanted and asked in their ole for the alumni's permission to continue the tradition and legacy of our luau.
We are very excited to have all of you joining us here tonight, and we hope you feel the same. Now get ready, folks, because for tonight, for the first time in luau history, we have celebrity guest MCs. Coming straight from the Grammys, in transit to the Academy Awards,
and on their way to see the Queen of England, and even making stops to see President Obama and Justin Timberlake, we have our celebrity guest MCs, so let's bring them out tonight.
Nah, just jokes. We couldn't fit that in the budget this year, so the three of us volunteered to do it. I'm Cherise Puniket, class of 2016 from Waialua, Hawaii, home of Paulakai Bakery, known for their delicious snow puppies.
And I'm Eddie Carrillo, class of two. Hi, Mom. class of 2015 from Milpitas, California, or as others would like to call it, the ninth island of Hawaii.
And I'm Donna Ramos, class of 2008, home of Kahuku, Hawaii, with the shrimp trucks and palusami, and we are your masters of ceremony for tonight.
Thank you for flying Hawaiian Airlines nonstop travel to Forest Grove, Oregon. We will now be pushing back the planes. We ask you to sit back and relax, or if you prefer to be upright and be uptight, that's fine too. In an unlikely event for an emergency, please use your hakules as a flotation device located under your seat.
Be sure to keep your slippers, lava-lavas, and plate lunches in your seat at all time, and your tray tables up in the full and upright positions.
And please, do not stand up and yell chihu until the seatbelt light is no longer illuminated. Now let's begin our festivities. Wait. Before we go, it is tradition that when you see something you like and when you enjoy what you're watching, that you all give out a chihu. So, to get you guys' vocal cords kind of warmed up, we're gonna do a practice chihu on the count of three. We're all gonna let one out and we're gonna let the dancers know that you're ready for them, all right? So on the count of three, let's go. One, 2, 3. There it is. Let's get it going. Go ahead, Cherise.
Composed in 1881, Chiefess Nahinu, a cousin of Queen Kapi'olani, composed this prayer for King Kalakaua, wishing him success and happiness on his long journey around the world. This chant speaks of seeing the beauty of the Himalayas, treading on billowing waves and sailing over the tranquil sea. This prayer spoke directly to King Kalakaua, saying, E ola o kalani a maoloa, may the heavenly one live on and on. This evening, the women of Naha Mana o Hawaii performed Ya oe e kala, to you, O sun.
This year's Kanekihiko performed Himele no Kalakaua, which was a mele created for the last reigning king of the Hawaiian Islands. When the king rose to sovereign power, this mele inoa, or name chant, proclaimed his highborn ancestry and asserted his right to rule. The poetic imagery in this hula alluded to Kalakaua's lineage from the islands of Maui and Hawaii.
For our next performance, we have the Wahine Awana. Hawaii is full of cultural diversity, beautiful sceneries, and an aloha spirit that is incomparable. The beauty of our culture is that the traditions are constantly handed down from generation to generation. From learning the native language to dancing songs to honor the royal family and our keakua. We not only strong in our culture, but we are also strong in our faith. And we are so incredibly thankful for all of our blessings. Tonight, the ladies of Naha Mana o Hawaii present to you a familiar song with a Hawaiian twist. Ladies and gentlemen, these beautiful wahines present to you Kauana Torres' version of Hallelujah.
Makani kui e kalono haina e ina molelo na e haola kou oiai maolo aku kola kono hona e hea aku ina mele akaiko onalohia kahali Kuina ike kuuna I aloha ia E ano ka haku e Hana ho mai ka lani e Ho nari a e no kako O nei o Kristo ko kago ho Moikane, ana hoa
So I just want all of you to know how lucky you guys are to be here tonight. Not only did you get a free concert that was not scripted, but that's okay, you guys enjoyed it, but you guys get to be a part of our competition happening right now. For the last 2 weeks, my fellow MCs, Sharice and Donna, have found two people to participate in our competition tonight, and we're gonna be having an UMMI show-off. So we're gonna have our two participants compete today, and then after, you guys are gonna show us who you think wins, and the winner will get a prize from the country store that all of you can visit during intermission to get snacks and goodies, whatever you guys want for the second half. So, without further ado, let's take it away to Sharice over here on the east side of the bleachers. She's got a participant with her. There she is.
Hi. All right, so with me I have Nicole George. This is America's Next Top Model's recent winner of this past season. Woo! Everybody give it up for Nicole. All right, so in her free time, she likes to come to Pacific University and study environmental studies. Are you ready tonight?
Yeah.
All right, so here she goes. You want to stand up?
Oh, sure. Why not?
I got the beat for you, don't worry. Ready? Oh, great job. I don't know that. Honestly, that might be pretty hard to beat. But Donna's over here on the other side with her participant. Let's figure out where Donna's at. She's somewhere.
I'm hard to see, I'm Filipino.
There she is, yeah.
There we go. All right, so for our next contestant, we have Aiden. He just came straight from the Disney castle, 9 and a half going on 16. He's been practicing for about a few weeks, all matched into about 30 seconds because I just asked him to participate in this. He's going to be showing his dance moves from So You Think You Can Dance. All right.
You ready, buddy? Yeah. I'll get the beat going for you. Let's go. Ready? Here's where it gets fun. Will all the people here tonight, the audience, please pull out your cell phones. If you like contestant one, text contestant one to 808-888-8888. If you like contestant two, text contestant two to 808-888-888. I think that's seven numbers, 888. And the results are in. For the first time in Luau history, we have a tie. And both contestants are winners. Let's give it up for them. Both contestants are gonna be walking away with some cookies from the country store. Like I said, don't forget to hit them up during intermission. They got cookies, other stuff that I don't remember, and they got some good snacks, so don't forget to go. This year, the freshmen of Naha Mana o Hawaii would like to perform for you the dance stylings of Kawai Christostomo to the song Hano Hano Kale Pikake by Kaylee Iraishel. Just like the exquisite pikake flower, Kaylee parallels the aspects of the flower to a beautiful woman whom he adores. Please enjoy as the freshman grace the stage with a beautiful dance to Hano Hano Kale Pikake.
Oh,
Is a dance dedicated to our ali'i, showing them respect with handheld standards called kahili. Kahili are a symbol of royalty, a matter of communication, and a way to set barriers and boundaries. They are made from handheld collected bird feathers crimped onto wooden standards, and Auntie Mary Louise Kekuweva was an expert in Hawaiian featherwork, which held many values in the Hawaiian culture.
It required discipline, focus, and perseverance. During the winter term of 2013, six Pacific students were given the opportunity to learn about kahili from their daughter, Auntie Paulette Kahalepuna, in their shop Nalimi Mili Hulu No'eau. Kahili were once a way to let everyone know who the family, royal family were, but today they are a constant reminder of our Hawaiian heritage and culture.
Thank you.
Hawaii state motto of Uamau Kea o ka aina I ka pono translates into the life of the land is perpetuated in righteousness. To the original Hawaiians, the land was and always will be life. Hawaii 78 reflects the change in treatment of the land in Hawaii. It reveals a grief and loss that the past kings and queens would feel now to see the land covered with pavement, highways, and condominiums. Through this dance, feel the emotion of the dancers and the hope that this message will awaken in the present a better management of the beauty and the righteousness of our land.
And then yet you'll find
Have you ever seen a girl from afar that just catches your eye, or met a girl that just never seems to leave your mind? Everything in your world seems to revolve around that special girl, and you would do anything for her. All you want to do is be her superhero, to save her from danger, or even cross an ocean just to be with her. This is a small price to pay to have the woman of your dreams. This medley of Honey Baby by 3PLUS and Stuck on You by Ekolu will capture that moment. Watch as the couples of Naha Mana o Hawaii show us that true love is always worth fighting for. While traditionally a woman's dance, legend says poi balls was first used by men to develop flexibility in their wrists to improve their use of hand weapons. The first half of the performance will be more traditional, exhibiting traditional costumes and dance movements. The second half of the performance will be using glow poi, giving this traditional dance a modern twist.
just cause everybody doing what they all do.
Just yet, it's time to take the poi balls up a notch. Poi was originally used by the Maori people of New Zealand as a form of exercise to train for battle and hunting. Spinning the heavy poi developed wrist strength and flexibility for handling tools and weapons. Eventually, poi became used as a form of storytelling and dance. The introduction of poi into Polynesia led to the creation of fire poi, a modernized form of poi dance that utilizes variations of traditional techniques.
Thank you.
This Fa'a Tau Pati, or Samoan slap dance, is a display of strength and stability. The slap dance is performed by slapping the body to make a noise or rhythm. The slap dance is performed at almost every event, including weddings, birthdays, or even church functions. So get ready, folks, as we take a journey to the island of Samoa. Thank you.
This song goes out to all the brothers and sisters out there who have been away from the islands for too long. Whether you moved away, or at college, or just on a long vacation, we know how you feel.
Feels like longer than forever, yeah. My home is now a distant land. If I had one wish, I wish I could be back on that rock in the middle of the sea. My heart is calling me to the islands, blue skies and tropical breeze. I wanna go back home to swim in that Pacific Sea. You can take the boy from the island, but not the island from the boy, 'cause the island stays in your heart. Play lunch, ooh, what a winner. Call the brothers up,
we got ballina.
My heart is calling me to the islands, blue skies and tropical breeze. I wanna go back home to swim in that Pacific Sea. You can take the boy from the island, but not the island from the boy. The island stays in your heart, and I'll never forget where I'm from. Oh no, I'll never forget where I'm from. No, I'll never forget.
I'm really from this island, just the island where I'm from. Don't know local girls, 'cause they are the number one. That kick I wanna be, 'cause when I leave this island I'll be
sorry that I left you, yes, and I will never forget you, no, no.
Forget you, no, no, me never to let you go. Yes, me can't stop, won't stop, till me find my way back home. And when me return, return to the island finally, moving like the ocean and down.
Sorry that I left you.
Beautiful life we're living today. Care, yeah.
Drew Carney's getting ready for the party this morning. Drew, fabulous. What's going on?
Good morning, Stephanie. We come to you this morning from the beautiful Pacific University campus, where again this weekend a wonderful annual event returns. We're talking about the Pacific University Hawaiian Club Luau. Now in its 55th year, we're going to bring you a preview with the students, a smiling batch of students coming up.
This morning, Drew is getting a taste of the Hawaiian Islands, and he's only had to travel to Forest Grove.
The last time you saw me, gang, I was weaving through the student body as they were dancing on stage. I will not be weaving through this group of students because they're playing with fire this morning. Yes, getting ready for the 55th annual Pacific University Hawaiian Club Luau. It is this weekend with a preview this morning. Hold it! Hold it! Fire on the stage this morning. We'll have more coming up.
Yeah.
This morning, Mr. Carney is hanging out with the Hawaiian Club at Pacific University out in Forest Grove.
Their annual luau is coming up this Saturday. It's really a long-standing... My mouth has just decided. No more, Steph. We will not talk. It's a long-standing tradition. It's in its 55th year.
It's actually one of my favorite out-and-about segments. Drew is getting a little preview on campus this morning. So, you've got the fire dancers? No, we've moved on. What are they twirling around?
Fire, well, they're twirling around some poi balls right now. We did see the fire dancing a moment ago. I thought fire dancing for a little tease, like we just had a moment ago, good. Fire dancing for 3.5 minutes could be dangerous. So fire off the stage, the fellas are out. The ladies are on the stage this morning. They are all students here at Pacific University. They are all getting ready for this weekend's 55th annual Hawaiian Club Luau right here on this beautiful campus. Real quickly, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to come out to the event, it starts with a delicious dinner, a luau-style meal at 4:30 p.m. on Saturday at what's known as the University Center. And then at 6:30 p.m. right here in the Stoller Center, they put on this fantastic show with fantastic Polynesian music and dancing, entertainment all night long. So here we are this morning getting ready for this event. I'm glad you like this segment, Brenda Braxton, because we do it every year. It's the 55th year of the event, and it feels like I've covered all 55. Paige, one of the students out here getting ready for the event on Saturday. So one question I have for you, I've known and I've learned over the years that there is a large concentration of islanders making up the student body here at Pacific University. Any idea what that percentage is right now this year?
I think it's about like one-third, like 33%.
33% of the students at this university are from the Hawaiian Islands.
Yeah, amazing.
Why would that be? Is there a reason? Can you pinpoint a reason?
I think it's due to the good outreach programs we have and the programs we offer here, such as taking them out to explore the Pacific Northwest or having like mentor programs so they don't get homesick. And just participating in Luau helps them practice to perpetuate the Hawaiian culture.
A family environment here at Pacific. Let's talk about the dance. Camera Steve loves to show the boy ball dancing while he's looking at it and showing our viewers about it. Tell me about I know that all the dances usually during your show have a meaning. What is the significance of the poi ball dance?
Well, traditionally it was used by men to develop flexibility in the wrist when they're using their weapons. But as you can see now, it's mainly done by women.
I was going to say, these are not men I'm looking at this morning, Paige. It's been a while since I've been in college, but I know that these are not males. These are females. So how do you work the poi balls like that? Because they're doing a great job back there. Can you give me a lesson?
Okay. Well, first you can start simple with just a basic. Swing it forward. Yeah. And then...
Paige, I'm doing it, am I not?
Yeah. You're doing it well.
Thank you.
Next, we'll do a butterfly. So you can put your arms together, or your hands
together.
Let me
see you do it first.
And then you're gonna put your bottom one in your pinky.
What? You had it, okay.
And then do it in one hand.
Are we still doing it, Paige? Are we still doing it? Because I feel like I'm doing it, but not as well as you're doing it.
No, it looks similar.
You are just being kind this morning. You stop it. Pacific University putting on its 55th annual Hawaiian Club Luau. Ladies, keep poi balling this morning because you do it a lot better than I do. We will have more dancing, haka style. Russ, Stephanie, and Brenda coming up in the 6 o'clock hour. Yes, haka.
Now you're talking.
And Drew, let the club know it's currently 73 in Honolulu at 3:49 in the morning.
Oh.
That makes me
I saw a couple of these students step outside a moment ago, and they're like, whoa, it's freezing out there.
Yes, it is. It's all relative. Oh, that's fun. So is that a unisex skirt? Because he's dressed like the ladies.
Oh, he doesn't. It doesn't affect him at all. It doesn't matter.
Right. I don't know.
Unisex
maybe it
or
is.
Otherwise. Yeah. It might be, though.
It's not the first time he's
just a good thing
better
to throw a speedo under that.
Mm-hmm.
There's potential for that still, so be careful. All right, let's go future cast because...
To the people at PALS.
Yeah, plus we are checking in with Drew this morning. He's all Hawaiian.
I noticed last hour, Brenda, that you and Stephanie and Russ were all having fun with the skirt I am wearing this morning. So I thought I would distract you. I thought I would distract you in the 6 o'clock hour with this blinding white light. Yes.
Yes.
We are on the campus of... Turn down the light.
What do the Hawaiians think of that?
We are on the campus of... That man's been in Oregon too long, they say, in the islands. We are on the campus, that is, on the campus of Pacific University. Their 55th annual Hawaiian Club Luau is this weekend. Yes, the students are on board for an early morning preview. We'll bring it to you in just a few minutes.
I love that. Okay, you guys, switching gears totally, a trip to Hawaii sounds fabulous right about
it
now.
It does, because you said it was like 73 degrees there this morning.
In the middle of the night.
I love it. Okay, Drew is getting a taste of the islands. He's at Pacific University in Forest Grove.
That taste right now, gang, comes courtesy of a dance known as Siva. Siva, done beautifully this morning by members of Pacific University's Hawaiian Club. They're putting on the school's 55th annual luau this Saturday. Coming up next, we'll preview the luau, not with the Siva, but with the dance known as the haka. Yes, the slapping of the legs, the shoulders, and the chest is next, right here on KGW News at sunrise.
It is 6:46, and this morning, Drew Carney is hanging out with the Hawaiian Club at Pacific University in Forest Grove.
Their annual luau is coming up Saturday. It's a long-standing tradition. 55 years they've been doing this.
They have, and Drew is in on the action. I'm not sure what that move is, but you're going to be doing the haka soon.
Yes, you'll see the haka move here in a moment. In fact, why don't we start this segment with these three words. Show me haka.
Kia wakarango, kia arite.
Yes, haka underway. And with that as my backdrop, I tell you that the Pacific University Hawaiian Club brings its 55th annual luau to this campus Saturday. There you see the details. They do a luau dinner at 4:30 at the University Center. They do a great show with the music and the dance at 6:30 right here at the Stoller Center. And again, it's the 55th year of this fantastic event. Gentlemen, I see you have stopped the haka, which is okay for now, but we will haka again together. Justin, I'm going to bring you into the mix. A senior here at Pacific University.
Yes.
Graduating in May, I would hope.
Yes.
With what sort of degree?
Business administration and marketing.
And are you from the Hawaiian Islands?
Yes, I'm from Oahu.
Because I know that more than 20% of the entire student body hails from the islands. You, again, one of them. So do you think when you graduate, you go back to Hawaii to pursue that career in business, or do you stay here? What do you think?
Eventually, I'm going to stay here first and try and find a job in the Portland area.
You know it's 70-something degrees right now in Hawaii.
It is.
It's not 70-something degrees right now here.
Definitely
not. That doesn't matter to you.
Nah.
Okay, you've become tough. You have become tougher here in the Oregon conditions over the last 4 years. I want to know a little bit about the haka. Gentlemen, can we see haka? You're going to have to talk loud over the haka. Can we see haka again? And while they do it, explain to me the significance of this dance, Justin. So start them first.
Kia arite, kia arite, kia mau.
Why the haka? What does this dance represent, Jeff?
This dance represents a Maori war chant, and what the tribes used to do before battle, they would do the haka to intimidate their adversaries before battle in order to get them to kind of back down or get a little fear in their hearts.
Do you think in the future when you're trying to strike a business deal and it's getting down in the nitty-gritty, you could throw the haka out there against whoever you're doing business with and maybe strike the deal that way?
I hope so. If it comes down to that, then I'll be more than willing to do the haka right in front of there on the table.
Show me a couple of haka moves, then I'll join the fellas to end the segment. Give me a good haka move, one, two, three kind of thing.
So the main ones is you slap your thighs. So what they do is kamate, kamate, kaora, kaora.
Kamate, kamate, kaora, kaora.
Kamate, kamate, kaora, kaora.
Kamate, kamate, kaora, kaora. Maybe a variation of Russ Lewis, Russ Lewis is Nick, Nick. Russ Lewis, Russ Lewis, Nick, Nick. How about just that work?
Yeah.
Can we do it all together?
Yeah, we can.
Okay, oh, bring it home, boys. Bring it home.
Charite. Kiarite, kiamo!
Russ Lewis, Russ Lewis, Nick, Nick! Russ Lewis, Russ Lewis, Nick, Nick! Russ Lewis, Russ Lewis, Nick, Nick!
Yeah!
That's the Nick, and that's the Allard. Pacific University Hawaiian Club Luau. I feel like you're staring at my chest now, and I'm not comfortable with that.
You're right.
Pacific University Hawaiian Club Luau, Saturday, right here on campus. Gentlemen, you were great this morning. Gang, back to you.
It's the Irish Hawaiian war chant. a little different.
What did you say? You said my eyes are up here.
Your eyes are up here.
I know.
Yeah, really.
He needs a tap like the guy behind him because he looks fierce.
He needs protection.
Some a little lightheaded now.
Some self-tanner, I know. I said he was our Disney reporter. He's Snow White.
Oh, yeah, don't you think?
He is.
Well, it could have been worse. They could have said dopey.
Oh, well, see, it's so good.
You know, hybrid. All right, this morning, bus stop forecast.